Hello, my name is Greg Adams. I'm an EMT firefighter with the City of Mesa Fire and Medical Department. This is Thad Hunter, paramedic engineer extraordinaire. Today we're going to be talking about shock. It's typically a secondary effect to something that we might see prior to our arrival within 4 minutes. Thad is going to give you a little insight on what may happen or occur prior to seeing those symptoms.
Yeah, thanks, Greg. Like Greg was saying, a lot of times shock is a secondary mechanism to an event that happened prior to us getting there, whether it be trauma, passing out, anaphylaxis, bee stings, and whatnot. Some of the things that you can do before we arrive in that 4 minutes is first, airway. If they're in a position where it looks like they can't breathe, try to open up their airway. Breathing, if they're not breathing, rescue breaths, but you know, that'd just be for a loved one. And then circulation. If there's active bleeding, what we'd like you to do is use direct pressure, either get a clean bandage or a towel, a sheet or something, and you'll wrap it with a little bit of pressure. You can elevate whatever is bleeding that limb above the heart. We can do pressure points. If you can find an artery back from where that bleeding is and apply pressure there, a lot of times that'll work. I know in the movies they use tourniquets on everything, but we highly advise not to use tourniquets because when you put a tourniquet on, it could cause tissue damage and sometimes it's irreversible. Other than that, we want you to make sure you try to keep the patient calm. You can elevate their legs as long as there's no trauma to them, about 8 to 12 inches. And lastly, keep them warm, and we should be there within that 4 minutes. If you guys have any questions or have any added things that you want to hear about, you can go ahead and leave us a message on Facebook or leave us a tweet on Twitter.